Good evening. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Foundation Performing Arts Center. Tonight, the Symphony of Rutherford County begins its 35th season. Joined by the Crest High School Chamber Orchestra, we celebrate the holidays. Please take a moment to familiarize yourself with the emergency exits. In the event of an emergency, please follow the direction of our event staff, those wonderful men and women in red bow ties. As a courtesy to your fellow patrons and the performers, please take a moment to silence your cell phone. Also, please remember the taking of flash pictures is prohibited. Tonight's program will have one 20-minute intermission. We would like to announce one program change. Due to illness, guitarist Tony Rogers will be unable to perform. The guitar parts in all Trans-Siberian Orchestra arrangements will be played by award-winning singer-songwriter guitarist and Summit Showcase Songwriter of the Year, Mike Alec. The symphony would like to thank Mr. Alec for stepping in at the last minute to play this very important and difficult role. Tonight's performance was made possible through the generous support of the North Carolina Arts Council, providing 50 years of leadership in the arts. The Stonecutter Foundation of Spindale, providing matching funds for donations made this season. Stan Thomas and B Sharp Music, and through the generous donations by patrons like you. Please help us show our appreciation to all of these fine sponsors. Now please welcome our concertmaster, Mr. Roy Price. Please make welcome our assistant conductor, Mr. Matthew Guffin. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Symphony of Rutherford County's conductor and music director from Gardner-Webb University, Dr. Patricia Sparty.
Welcome to our holiday and Christmas concert. It's so great to have you here tonight. And that was so beautifully played by the symphony and by our fantastic assistant conductor and principal clarinetist, Matt Guffey. So beautifully done. Wanted to mention that this year, you know, we have an entire season. You know, things are back to normal for the symphony. And last year we started back up on March 10th, we had the Christmas concert and then we did our children's program in March 10th. So we started in the fall, but we didn't play till December. But this year, on October 21, we did our children's concerts, and we did a Disney show for the kids. And it was great to see this hall filled twice in the same day by a pile of kids who were singing along and having a beautiful time, enjoying music, dance, and theatrical things, and they were having a beautiful time. And then here we are here tonight, celebrating Christmas and the holidays, and it's great to have you guys with us. And in the spring, we have two concerts as well, and I'm sure Dr. Womack will tell you about those, but our 35th anniversary concert's coming up April 30th at 3. Hope to join us, and then we're playing a totally different program, a Pops concert, on May 12th from 7 to 9 p.m. outside. So she will tell you about those, and I hope you can plan on being there. This is a Christmas festival by the great composer and arranger, Leroy Anderson. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Christmas song. Believe it or not, it was written by Mel Torme and Robert Wells during the hottest part of the summer. They were thinking cool thoughts. This is Greensleeves. Matt Riley, it's a great arrangement. What Child Is This? And this is featuring two of our players, Karen Johnson on cello and Billy Norton on violin. It also features a third player, our piano, who is now on a good amp. Yes, our piano, who is now on a good amp. Praise the Lord. Here we go. This is Greensleeves. Thank you. swinging holiday. So it is jazzed up. See how many Christmas tunes you can count. And this is a jazz version. Sleigh ride.
Thank you.
Was a Charlie Brown Christmas, and it's funny, now we come to Christmas around the world, and I remember one year, I was like, okay, I'm going to name the hymn, and you tell me, or the piece, what country it's from, and all the Crest students kept getting it, and I was like, man, they really learn a lot in high school, and then somebody said to me, it's on their piece of paper, the music. And I was just like, man, they're good, but at least, you know, they cooperate. I would say one country and they would scream it out and raise their hands. The adults were there like, oh. So, okay, so let's do our quiz. Go tell it on the mountain. You guys should know that one. I went out of order. USA, hello. Infant, holy, infant, lowly. Poland. Yeah, the adults got that one. Hanukkah. Israel. Good job. Oh, Santissima. Oh, Santissima. Thank you. Thought you would get that one. Oh, Tannenbaum. Yes. What child is this?
England.
Nice. And do you know it's more popular in the United States than it is, but it was originated in England. And the guy that wrote it was in a deep depression when he wrote it. And it's been this beautiful, beautiful thing that was revealed to him for many, many years. Okay, so here's the last one. Whence comes this rush of wings? Is a traditional what, Carol? I don't do Francais very well. It's French. Okay, so here we are. We're going around the world Christmas time.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. You're such a joy to play for. We're going to take an intermission, and then we will be back with Rock Out the House, Baby, Trans-Siberian Orchestra. We have 6 Trans-Siberian pieces and White Christmas.
Thank you, and thank you for being here. Maybe it's a little late to say welcome, but welcome again. We're so happy to have you with us tonight. Your support of the symphony is appreciated more than you know. This is your local homegrown orchestra, now in its 35th year of serving the community through music and music education. We will be celebrating that milestone at our spring concert on April the 30th. Be sure you go home and put that on your calendar. And while you're at it, also put May the 12th, which is going to be our concert at the Pops Outdoor Theater in Forest City. So that's going to be a lot of fun, too. And it will be 2 different shows. We'd also like to thank those who have already contributed to our fund drive. You know, it takes a lot of money to run this orchestra. If you haven't done so already, one of our guild members would be glad to take your contributions after the concert, or you can donate securely online at our website or Facebook page at rcsymphony.org. And the great news is, I think Russell alluded to this earlier, thanks to a generous matching grant from the Stonecutter Foundation, every dollar you give will be doubled, up to a total of $10,000. We're very appreciative of that, as well as the other grants we receive from the Arts Council, the Kiwanis Club. Most important is you as our audience. You are our lifeblood, and without you, we would be empty voices singing in the wind. Some other people I would like to thank tonight are the young people that you see around the cameras. These are students of Carolyn Young, and we're so grateful to her and her class for videotaping our concert. And I want to thank every musician that you see on the stage, most of whom donate their time and talents on a volunteer basis, come into regular practices almost every Saturday morning. That in itself is a great example of service, dedication, and love. We're also grateful for our guest artists. You know, we're a volunteer orchestra, and we just don't have all the positions volunteered. So sometimes we have to bring in other people. We're very happy that they're here tonight. And we're especially grateful for Peter Strickland's Crest High School Chamber Orchestra. And again, I want to I would like to thank Mike Alec, who stepped in just 2 days ago as our electric guitarist for the Trans-Siberian Orchestra portion. Sit back now and enjoy the rest of the show, and happy holidays to all of you.
Prepare to rock out. Everybody get their fingers up. Yeah, baby. You can dance You can stand up and dance. Prepare to rock. This is so funny. With the jacket on, the Crest kids all thought that I had had my wrist tattooed. I was like, wow, that's really cool.
Yeah.
For tonight. So prepare to rock out, Trans-Siberian. Yep. I'm dreaming of a white Christmas first, however.
Thank you.
is.
Fast rock.
Thank you.
This is an Appalachian snowfall. Did this, I actually got on the stage and danced, but we have a different setup, so there's not enough stage. I would actually probably dance off the stage, but the last time the stage was empty, and so this is fun music to dance to. This is the famous one, Christmas Eve, Sarajevo, 24/7. Thank you. Strickland, come up. Mr. Strickland, come up. Peter Strickland, come up. Matt, come up. Trans-Siberian Orchestra, come up. Okay, so we're going to have some cheering to do here. Trans-Siberian's also making their way up. So this is Peter Strickland and my 25th collaboration, as I said, with either Gardner Webb Orchestra and Crest Chamber Orchestra, or the Symphony of Rutherford County and Crest Chamber Orchestra. And believe it or not, his kids just did a concert with Gardner Webb November 21, totally different program, did this tonight, and next week, is it on Thursday? They do a totally different program. All the kids who come out of his program read like crazy and are great musicians. He is Teacher of the Year, every day in my book. Let's hear it from Mr. Strickland and Crest High School Chamber Orchestra. Our amazing assistant conductor, great clarinetist, great conductor. Let's hear from Matt Guffey. Okay, so I want to bring up the Trans-Siberian Orchestra.
They're here.
They're here. Oh. So I want to hear it for, we're going to say the Symphony of Rutherford County in just a minute. So let's bring up our rockers. Woo! Rock on! That in less than 48 hours, much less than 48 hours, he learned all those parts. Woo! Mike Alec! Mike Alec rocking it on the lead guitar. Wow! We have Gail Wilson on the piano, rocking the keys! John Sinderman, he is the man on the drum set. And there is yet another Strickland. We've had Peter Strickland. Last year, Kate Strickland was right here next to Roy, our fantastic concertmaster. This year we have another Strickland. This is Emily Strickland rocking it on the electric bass. Okay, make sure you stay. She also played acoustic bass. So now let's hear it for the Symphony of Rutherford County. Now let's hear it for all the rockers, the Symphony of Rutherford County, and the Crest Chamber Orchestra is here for tonight. Is there anything I want to wish you all a Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, Happy Kwanzaa, etc., and a very Happy New Year. We want to see all of you, plus everybody brings 10 people, to our 35th anniversary concert. It's Sunday, April 30th, 3 p.m., right here in the greatest hall. We want to thank Russell Wicker. We want to thank James Brink. We want to thank our sound. Garth, he's the best in the business. Garth, our sound guy. So, in this beautiful hall, Sunday, April 30th, 3 p.m., is our 35th anniversary concert for the symphony. Imagine that, the symphony's older than I am. Oh boy, you know, they used to pause. There's not a pause anymore. Okay, I get it. So, and then, of course, on May 12th, 7 to 9 p.m., Dr. Womack, where is it? Pops at the theater at Forest City. So there are different programs. Russell wanted me to remind you that you can't not come here on the 30th because there are two totally different programs. 35th anniversary concert, Pops concert. And we'll have some of our Disney characters and things back at the Pops, so bring your kids. And want to thank Dr. Womack, who has been an amazing president, done so great with this orchestra. And every single player on this stage, the craft that they have, the dedication they have, let's hear it for all the players. So, thank you so much. If you want to come up and visit. So if you want to visit with your players, you can, and have a wonderful and blessed night. Thank you.